A quick reminder, we've released the first chapter of our Graphy, War Transformed, talking about the evolution of warfare through history. Graphy is an app where various creators make stuff, a learning resource if you'd like. If a story of stone weapons and ancient warfare sounds cool, do check out the link in the video description below, taking you to our Graphy app page. US Ford-class aircraft carriers have one ship in commission, another one being built, and at least two more planned. They're the newest and most powerful class of US carriers, with a bunch of new technologies, like the electromagnetic catapults for launching the planes. The lead ship carries the name of US President Gerald R. Ford. The second one goes on with the presidential theme, invoking the name of US President John F. Kennedy. Coincidentally, that's the second time a US carrier bears his name. The third ship broke away with the recent tradition of naming carriers after presidents and reuses one of the oldest names in the US Navy, Enterprise. Also, it will be the third time a US carrier bears that name. Finally, the fourth Ford-class carrier got its name earlier this year, and it's going to be called Doris. Doris Miller. Those who know all the US presidents' names by heart will know Doris Miller was not a president. Doris Miller was a US sailor who was serving on the US Navy battleship West Virginia during the attack on Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941. His role on the ship was one of a mess attendant. The morning of the attack, he was serving breakfast and was on laundry duty. When the attack commenced, he went to his battle station, but discovered that part of the ship was already destroyed. He was subsequently given an order to help move the ship's wounded captain to a more protected spot. But the captain would not leave his post, so Miller was given other orders. He was to help operate 50 cal AA guns. Even though he was expected to feed ammo to the gun, in the midst of the battle, he found himself shooting. He had not received any official training for that task, yet he showed great courage, actively fighting the enemy. He was awarded the Navy Cross afterwards, as he had also helped carry the wounded during the battle, after his gun ran out of ammo. In that process, he helped save lives of a number of fellow crewmates. Sadly, he was killed in 1943, going down with his ship Liscombe Bay, after it was sunk by a Japanese submarine. He was 24 years old at the time. For those who expected someone named Doris to be female, you'd be more likely to be correct had all this happened today. Even though there were a few women serving on ships in the US Navy back in World War I, in practice that was a rarity. It was not until the 1970s that women started to serve on ships in large numbers. And is Doris a female name? Well, in today's US, it is mostly. Since the end of the 1980s, there have been only a few or no boys named Doris born per year. While Doris as a girl's name has persisted at a little under 100 newborn girls getting that name per year in the last two decades. That's a far cry from the late 1920s, when Doris was the sixth most popular girl's name. In 1919, when our Doris Miller was born, there were some 60 or so boys named Doris born. And the name never really took off for boys, rising up to 100 or so per year in the 1920s before slowly dwindling down in numbers. Also, this will be the first time a US carrier is named after an African American. But it will not be the first time any US Navy ship bore Doris Miller's name. A Knox-class frigate in the 1970s and 1980s, USS Miller, got that honor first. The carrier, CVN-81, Doris Miller, is currently in the prep phase, so it can be laid down in 2023 and launched by 2028. Of course, carriers take a long time to actually get inducted into service, so commissioning is planned for 2030, and her first active duty mission will likely come 2 years later. As with any Ford-class carrier, a 100,000-ton behemoth of considerable firepower, the ship will be feared.